just wanted to comment on what happened last night. Jordyn came running out of the room and said that the tall man was in a room, and then the door slammed. Which, to be honest, I nearly wet myself. But okay, so I ran into the room. The door was locked. I mean, you can see on the video, I'm trying to open the door, and it's just not coming open. And when I forced my way in, there was nobody in there. And it sent a chill down my spine. It was serious. I went to the library. Like, I was trying to say that I went to the library yesterday, and I made some notes. The realtor that sold me the house is going to have some questions to answer to. Apparently, I think I said it, but apparently the house is known as the Black Mansion in these parts. It was owned in the 1860s by a man named Cecil Black. He was an illusionist, entertainer, something like a minor Houdini, is what I was told. There was a great fire that destroyed the entire historic district of California, and Cecil was killed during that. Now, ever since then, the house that I bought has sat vacant. Several attempts have been made to try to repair the house to get it livable, and people tend to vanish from the grounds, or at least that's the urban legend. I don't really put too much stock in these things, but after seeing what's been going on with my daughter, I'm kind of keeping an open mind. Now, this morning, I found a letter tacked to my door from somebody named Cristy Black. It's odd, the last names. But it says, Mr. McKenzie, it is imperative that I reach you concerning the house you've purchased. Before you return to the grounds, give me a call at 706-341-3750. I called the number, and she didn't answer. It was a voicemail, and it directed me to a email account. Well, I've emailed her, and I'm waiting for her to respond either by phone or by email, but we will go from there as soon as I get in touch with her. So, as soon as I know more,